In this video, we're going to learn to use the crystal fill tool. And to begin, I will just start a new empty workspace, select a shape tool, and draw some kind of a shape. Now I'm going to select that shape, come to the fill properties tab, and change it to crystal fill. So when you choose a crystal fill, there are unique properties that can be adjusted to really change the appearance of the shape and the way that it's filled with crystals. And the first thing you're going to choose is the type of crystals you're using. And we have different palettes that are available to select from here. And certainly Swarovski Round is a very common palette to choose. And then the second choice is the size of the crystals. And of course, crystals come in many different sizes. And so if you've purchased crystals and you know they come anywhere from 5 SS5 up to SS48, which I think can be, you know, a lot of them are 2 millimeters, 3 millimeters, 4 millimeters wide, and so on. So I'm currently set for SS10 crystals. And the next choice is the color of the crystal that you are using. And so in this case, I can select from quite a large list of different colors that are available within the palette that I've selected. So if I choose this crystal sort of purple color, it will adjust. Now, the next choice, this is the style of fill the crystals are being applied in. And right now it's set for shape fit. There's rectangular fit, circular fit, contour fit, single line, shape fit, and line fit. And each one of these will change the appearance of the way the crystals fill in the shape, some more than others. Let's change it from shape fit to rectangle fit. And you'll notice that the shapes still go across in rows and columns, but they don't. Shape fit got it to really stick to the outer shape. So maybe perhaps more appropriate than rectangle. Circular fit, well, now you can see it's clearly creating a special circular pattern in the background. We also have contour, which will kind of use the shape to go inside sort of smaller and smaller and create a contour. We have single line, which will take the shape and draw a line down what it thinks is the middle of it. Shape fit, which we've seen already, and line fit. And you can see how each one creates a unique pattern. Now, in each case, with whatever selected, so let's go to rectangle fill, we have many properties that can be adjusted, and these properties will adjust based upon the style of fill. So for a rectangle fill, I can change the offset, item rotation, horizontal and vertical spacing, a start angle, and a slant angle. But if I change that to be, for example, I don't know, the single line, well, then I have less options. I can now only control the offset, the item rotation, and the horizontal spacing. And I think one thing to keep in mind with all of these is that an array has a lot of different uses, as you've seen in other videos, not just for crystals. And so some of these, like for example, item rotation, well, for a circular crystal, I don't think it really matters what item rotation we use, whereas that may be more valuable when using an array from a piece of artwork. But we really want to control things like the vertical and horizontal spacing. So if they're set at 1 millimeter, if I change this to 2 or 3 millimeters, then you'll see how that adjusts. So that's 3 millimeters horizontal. Now let's make it 3 millimeters vertical. Oh, that is 3,000. Well, that's interesting. How about just 3? And so these are the ways that we can adjust the appearance of a crystal fill mathematically. And as always, when we're using the array tool, we also have the ability to use the edit nodes tool. And when I turn on edit nodes, it gives me some specific nodes that could be used to adjust our array. And those nodes are more visual, a visual way of adjusting the same properties. So let me go ahead and get closer to this so that we can see what happens when I choose edit nodes. And if I select the one in the center of this angle, I could choose the location of the rows. If I use the bottom right, I can adjust the starting angle. So that tells you what direction these rows will travel along. This is called the slant, and it's currently set at 90, but I can use the top angle to adjust that slant to any degree, which would create more of an offset to the patterns. I can also use it to control the vertical spacing between the rows, and so in this way you can really create unique and interesting arrangements to your crystal fills, and you can basically adjust these until you've created the appearance that you were trying to achieve in a more visual fashion. So of course, if you know specifically the settings, perhaps it's a pattern you've used in the past, you can come in and just simply type them in. But I like to use the Edit Nodes tool to make these adjustments. Now let's change from rectangle to, for example, circular. And so now I don't have as many adjustments in my properties. For example, I have horizontal spacing, but not vertical spacing. However, I have a new option that's called the number of steps, which is currently set to 6. Let's turn it up to 8. And you'll see what it does. It creates its the number of times that it goes around the circle, and then the spacing will determine how many circles get created. So again, you can type all the numbers in, or you can use the Edit Node tool to come in and adjust the spacing. So how close, how many rows are you getting? And then with this, the number of steps. So if you want less steps, you can create less steps to your circle array. That's 5, 6. And each time you increase the number of steps, it will give you a visualization of those results. And so by bringing it in, we can make a lot of very tight circles, or bringing it out, we can make more open circles. So you can easily learn by just playing with simple shapes and adjusting these different fill properties. So let's look at contour, and let's maybe make the spacing smaller so you can see what a contour does to the overall shape. It's going around and around and around our shape in a contouring fashion. And so learning to use the Edit Nodes tools to make these adjustments, I think, really makes it successful for being able to create unique and interesting effects. Single line, as well as shape fit. And with shape fit, now see here, the start angle is set at 5 degrees. And with this particular shape, I think if I move that back to 0, see how that allows it to fall along the shape? Okay, so that is crystal fill and how you can use the properties box and the Edit Nodes tool to adjust all of the properties of a crystal fill. Now, one more thing about crystal fills is that, of course, we're going to be using our digital cutting machine to cut a template to create the actual crystal pattern. And so we have the ability to set the cutter presets right here within this object properties. And if you know the settings you want, you can type them in. If not, you can simply choose cutter presets, which gives you a list to choose from. And so, for example, if I was using my edge and I was doing crystals and I had smooth crystal material, I would choose this. And it would automatically pre-seed all of the information into my cutter presets. And that way, if I chose File and Export to Cutters, those properties would be transferred with the digital file to the cutting machine. Finally, one more thing that we'll talk about with a crystal fill is that at times, we may want to release these crystals from this fill as they are now. It's a crystal fill shape. It's a fill with crystal fill. But the very bottom property here was called Separate to Crystals. And what that does is, if you've created a fill and now you wish to make small adjustments, perhaps there's just one crystal that needs to be moved or deleted or added. If I choose Separate to Crystals, it will take all the crystals and make them individual segments of my design. They come grouped together, and if I right-click, I could ungroup them. That way, when I let go, literally each individual crystal is an individual object of our design, and like I said, could be added to or deleted as needed. And that comes up with more unique shapes. You may find, and I will have an additional video that I will record about overlapping crystals, and in that case, we'll learn a little bit more about adding and deleting crystals when that is needed. So that is our video on learning to use the crystal fill tool.